Hello everyone, Johnson Sensei here to give you a step-by-step tutorial on how to collaborate using Google Docs. Here I have a blank starting screen for my web browser. I'm using Google Chrome today. And from here, we will go directly to the Google Doc homepage. Do that by typing in Google Docs to the address bar. And here is the Google Docs homepage. So today we will be creating a new Google Doc and inviting a group member to work on it together with us. To make a new Google Doc, click the plus on the top left side. And here we have our new Google Doc. First things first, let's add a title. Collaboration in Google Docs. Very nice. All right, and here we have our main Google Doc here. This is a Google Doc to explain how to collaborate using the Google Workspace. Great. But right now, it's still only me in this Google Doc. I need to invite my group member to come and help me out. On the top right side of your Google Doc screen is a blue share button. This is how you will add your group members or your classmates to a Google Doc that you want to collaborate with them on. So click this share button and you will have a menu pop up that suggests adding an email on the top or sharing the document with a whole group of people. Today, let's stick with inviting somebody by their email. My group member today is the wonderful Cecilia Sensei. So let's invite her by typing in her email. Up, and she's right there already. So you can click the email if it pops up here, or you can keep typing directly into the menu. I will click Cecilia Sensei's email here. Here, you can choose whether or not to notify or send an alert to your group member. I think it's a good idea to notify them. And also to add a nice message to explain what you are sharing and why. Hello, Cecilia Sensei. This is our collaboration example doc. Please join me. Best regards, Johnson. All right. So if you click this send button, your group member, in this case, Cecilia Sensei, will get an email that will let her know I have invited her to help with this Google Doc, and it will include a link to this Google Doc that she can click and join me right away. So let's send. And now we will wait for Cecilia Sensei to join us in our Google Doc. While I'm waiting, I will add a little bit more information. Ah, there she is. So up on the top right side, you can see who is working on the doc at that moment. And in the Google Doc, you can see where the person who is working right now is typing. If it's a very long document, you can click that person's face and the document will move to show you where they are. This is a great way to collaborate together with your groupmates. If you highlight a piece of text, you can do a few different things to give your group member some feedback. On top, the blue sign is a comment. If you click Add Comment and say whatever you like, Thank you. Your group member will be able to see your comment and also reply directly to your comment. You can also, up on the top, right now I am editing. If you are editing, everything that you do in the document will automatically be changed. If you change to suggesting, however, all of your typing and additions will become suggestions and not edits. So you can see here. Now, I've made a change, but it is not a final change, it's just a suggestion. This is very good to use when you're not sure what you want to do next and just want to give a suggestion to your group members. On the top of the screen, you can see right now that we have our toolbar, which shows us all of the information about our group members. Sometimes, though, the menu might be hidden. For example, if your screen looks like this and you cannot see your group members, double check that you have this arrow on the right side, click, and your menu will come back. This is very useful, so please remember to double check your arrow on the top right. When you are writing a comment, again, we will highlight and click comment over here. If you start with an at mark, you can send a direct message to anyone that you are working with. If I add this at the beginning of my comment, Cecilia Sensei will get a notification to show her that I have a comment I would like her to read. If I want to make sure that she checks the comment and does something about it, I can assign this comment to her, and she will have to check, make sure it is complete, and then mark when she is finished with this comment. So let's assign it for here. And you can see Cecilia Sensei is adding comments right now, and I can reply. She suggests that instead of tagging or targeting comments, this can be called tagging somebody, which seems a little bit more familiar to students who are very used to SNS. So after you send a reply to your group member, if you are finished with this conversation, you can click the check and the comment will disappear. Up here as well, if you make a suggestion and you decide it's okay, if you check, the suggestion will turn into an edit. And then up on the top here, you can double check and turn back to editing to get ready to finish up the document. The great thing about Google Docs is that you can see who in the group has done what part of the work, when they were working, and what they added or subtracted. So let's start from the left side. On the top left, there is a notification that shows you who was editing when. So you can see through here which person added which piece of text. Now this is a quite short document, so let's look at a longer document with a longer history to really show the great power of Google Docs. Here is the English study resources that Cecilia Sensei and I have made for students. We have been working on this for quite some time, so our editing history is much longer, and you can see in detail when and where the different collaborators have added. So for example, if we go through here, we can see, so Cecilia Sensei deleted this link. It is marked in purple, and she deleted it at 5:49 today. Wonderful way to check who is doing what. For example, if you have a question, what is this link? You can check who added that link, and then you can ask them directly what was going on. All right. Another thing that you can do is check who has viewed the document. So not just the people who have edited, but the people who have looked at the document and when they looked. You can see that we have shared this document with many of our Google Classrooms, and you can go through and look when the last time they looked was. Cecilia-sensei looked this afternoon, and I looked within an hour ago. You can also check viewer trends, comment trends, but the most interesting parts are shared with, and then who was looking at the document. You can also check the comment history. For example, if you write a comment and resolve the comment, but want to go back and see who was writing what and when, you can open up this comment history and check to see all of the previous comments between the group members. Very, very handy. Let's go back to our example document. You can also open up a chat and directly talk to your group members as you work together. Oops. This is kind of like a Google chat that you are only talking with the other people who are currently inside the Google document. So this is best when you're all working at the same time. Maybe not so useful if you're working separately. If you're working separately, stick with the comments. And over here again, we can see the viewer history. This is useful if you have shared it with many different people and are not sure who has looked at it yet. But again, here we have only the two of us, and we've both looked at it within the last hour. All right, so that is the tutorial for how to do collaborative work or group work using Google Docs. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please let us know. We are happy to help. Hopefully you can have some great group work using Google Docs, using all of these tips we have shared today. Bye-bye.